Hello, everyone. So I will be doing my June wrap up. June was a very busy month for me, so I only read three books. So let's get started. The first book I read in the month of June was Swords of Summer. It is the first book in the Magnus Chase and the Gods of Asgard series by Riordan. Riordan also wrote Percy Jackson. So there's no surprise to why I wanted to read this book. I saw a lot of other booktubers talk about this, and so I knew I had to read it. It is a middle grade fantasy series about a kid named Magnus Chase who is living on the street after the mysterious death of his mother. A man tracks him down and tells him that he is the son of a Norse god and that he needs to find the weapon to stop Ragnarok. From there, he goes on adventures in the Nine Worlds and fights off attacks from beings he never knew existed. So I really enjoyed this book. However, it is a middle grade series, so it isn't for everyone. Some people find it juvenile, which is fine, but I never had a problem with reading middle grade series. Some of the main negative comments I have been reading were that it is so similar to Percy Jackson, and so it was nothing new to them. I agree that it is very similar to Percy Jackson, but I like Greek mythology and I like Norse mythology, and so the different characters got me interested in both, and so the similarities didn't bother me. I'm so excited to read the second book. It is called The Hammer of Thor, and you know I love Thor, so I will be definitely continuing with this series. The second book I read in the month of June was Luckiest Girl Alive by Jessica Knoll. I was very disappointed in this book. It was being compared to Gillian Flynn's book, and so I had high expectations that were not met. It focuses on a girl named Ani Finelli who seems to have the perfect life. She has an awesome job and a handsome, rich fiance. However, traumatic events from her past come to the surface and tries to ruin everything. Trigger warning for sexual assault and gun violence. So if those topics bother you, I would not read this book, especially since it is not handled the best. This book does have some interesting points to it, but overall it fell flat for me. I gave it 3 out of 5 stars in Goodreads. That's because I didn't hate it, but I didn't love it. And so I thought it was going to be like a mystery thriller book, and so it wasn't, and so I was very disappointed. And so that's why I didn't like it. And so I didn't want to judge it too harshly because my expectations weren't met. So maybe if I went in there having a different view on it, I would have liked it better, but I didn't. The third book I read in the month of June was Orange is the New Black, My Year in a Woman's Prison by Piper Kerman. I watched the latest season on Netflix, and so I just really wanted to find out like her real life story about it. It really disappointed me. It's about a memoir about how Piper Kerman, who committed a 10-year-old drug offense and is sent to prison. So it goes into how she found out she's going to prison and her life in prison. The reason I didn't like it was because nothing really happened. She's this privileged wasp who had a relatively easy time in prison. I mean, it is prison, so it isn't easy, but for her, she was just talking about how pretty she is and how popular she is and how she gets things because people like her. And so I just couldn't connect with it. I wanted to learn more about the prison and the hardships that these women face. But for her, there wasn't really any hardships. The other women in prison were talking about how hard it is going to find a job and finding a place to live, but she has a job already lined up and has a fiance who's buying a house. So there was no really struggle for her. I want to know about the other women and how strong they are and how they overcame the hardships. So I would want it to be more focused on them and not her because I didn't learn anything from her. I wanted more. So that is why I couldn't really connect with this book and I didn't really like this book. Those are the books I read in the month of June. So like and subscribe, and I'll see y'all later. Bye!